Back to the Storm Alert Center we go. You may have seen a shower, some sprinkles today, or it may have poured. In any case, it's soupy out there. You felt it in the air.
A little bit. You can still feel it. Just kind of muggy. The wind isn't blowing that strong, so it's just kind of a balmy evening. It's going to stay muggy through Thursday. Thursday afternoon, we're looking at scattered thunderstorms developing that will linger on through Friday morning. And then Friday afternoon into Saturday and Sunday, it's going to be cooler. We'll have lower humidity, and your holiday weekend should be absolutely flawless. Very quick look at our next tropical system. This one most likely will be a tropical storm by tomorrow, and you can see the path taking it through the rest of the week and into the weekend. By Sunday, moving across Cuba. By Monday, this could be turning to the north and becoming a tropical system impacting Miami. Of course, they're cleaning up from the condo that fell and trying to still recover and do their thing there, so that would not be good news for Miami, and all eyes in South Florida are on that developing tropical system. Here in the Tennessee Valley, just kind of a warm, muggy night, 80 degrees, my goodness, in Chattanooga, 77 Cleveland, 72 degrees in Murphy, and there are those calm winds. Heat index a little bit higher than the average, than the actual temperature. Pollen counts, if that's been something that's been bugging you, grass pollens are in the high category. Probably see it stay that way Thursday with the rain late Thursday into Friday. I think we'll not some of that pollen out of the air and see it come back a little bit on Saturday, although again, lower humidity and cooler weather may have trouble getting to the levels that we see now. 92 the high today in Chattanooga, 73 the low this morning. The record high was 107. Low 90s, upper 80s around the Tennessee Valley, 92 in Athens. Skywatchers calling in at Murphy, 87 degrees, 91 in Pikeville, and 88 degrees in Spring City. Got up to 93 in Red Bank, 83 Lookout Mountain, and 92 in Lakesite, 93 Chatsworth over into Somerville, 89 in Fort Payne. Quick look at our high-res radar showing again these showers and a couple of thunderstorms drifting northward, beginning to enter into southern Walker County. We'll zoom in on that area, and you can see them. Nice little stronger thunderstorm here drifting over. Might bring some heavy rain to the Fort Payne area and moving into Tryon, Somerville, some heavy rain. Not seeing anything severe. As a matter of fact, even the lightning has begun to fade away from that particular storm. We're going to see the potential for any storms at all dissipating as we move through the over. Night. And then tomorrow afternoon around 1 o'clock, we're going to start to see more thunderstorms firing up. They will produce some heavy rain at times. You can see how spotty everything is. We'll put the chance of rain at 60% for your Thursday evening into Thursday night. It's about 10 o'clock. And then overnight, not much until about 5-6 in the morning. Then we're going to have more heavy rain and thunderstorms moving through. Particularly, take a look at this heavier rain. It's going to dive to the south, south of Chattanooga. And I wouldn't put too much stock in this in terms of exactly where the heavy rain is going to be. I absolutely think we're going to have a wet commute on Friday morning, at least storm alert weather day, because that rain, especially in some spots, is going to be really heavy, and that's going to be the main threat. Heavy rain and lightning. I'm not expecting any severe weather other than that. As late as 11 o'clock, we'll still see that some of that rain drifting over to the Blue Ridge and down toward Calhoun and Rome, Georgia. And then by 1 o'clock in the afternoon, still some good showers around Ellijay, but as we continue through the afternoon, things will continue to dry out, and we'll have a high of only 82 degrees on Friday. Behind that front, northerly winds, cooler and drier air for Saturday and Sunday. It is going to be flawless both days of your holiday weekend. Temperatures in the mid-80s, low humidity, lows in the low 60s over the weekend. It's going to feel really good. Humidity builds back in on Monday, but it's going to stay dry on Monday also. Thursday, looking at about 3/4 of an inch to maybe an inch and a half of rain up around Dunlap, and then we'll add more onto that as we move into Friday. Heaviest rainfall amounts expected to be south of the city, up to 2-2.5 inches there. 1-1.5 inches of rain Thursday and Friday in on the Tennessee side. So tonight, increasing clouds, warm and muggy as we drop down into the upper 60s and low 70s. It's going to be muggy in the morning, and then scattered afternoon storms with a high of 88, or excuse me, a high of 88 in Chattanooga. I don't know why the 90 popped up in there, but it's going to be 88 tomorrow, 87 in Cleveland, and our storm alert 7-day forecast showing after the storm alert weather day, because of the heavy rain thunderstorms on Friday morning, the lawless weather for the 4th of July weekend. It is going to be a great weekend to celebrate, Greg.
David.